So there are lots of new note-taking applications on the market, and many of them are of interest to us here at Keep Productive. We're keeping our eyes on everything. However, there's five that are interesting me in particular that I wanted to zoom into, and something that I think are making waves right now. So welcome, my name is Francesco. I'm excited to dive into this feature. If you're in the hunt for productivity tools, you can head over to Tool Finder, which will be linked in the description below. And if you're looking for note-taking applications, there'll be loads there, including this full article if you just want to jump straight into the piece and read all about the five note-taking apps mentioned. Disclaimer, there are obviously loads of note-taking applications and apps that I've seen like NotesNook and the likes of Heptabase and many, many more are on our radar. And including Tana, we're checking them all out. So don't worry, more content will be coming soon about those. But let's dive into the five new note-taking apps that are on our radar. So first and foremost is Capacities. Now, this is a beautifully designed application, and it focuses on something called object-based note-taking, where each of your notes can stem from an object, which can be created inside of your Capacities account. It's a really interesting application that I've teamed up with Beth PKM to dive into all of the entirety of Capacities, if you want to check out the beginner's course, which will be linked below. But Capacities in itself has a lot of potential because what it does is it stems notes from objects, which entirely changes the way that notes are created. So you can create objects and build your own system, which is a really, really interesting approach. So something we're keeping our eyes on. Next up is an idea thinking tool. It's called Napkin, and it is a note-taking application that has a new and novel approach. What it does is it essentially allows you to store your notes that will be resurfaced, auto-tagged, and essentially brought up when relevant. They'll connect up with other notes as well to help you to bring ideas together and connect those notes that you've created. Now, this is a really interesting approach and something that I think the space is moving more into. Spatial-based productivity is something that's definitely on the top of my list to check out. And I think applications like this, Napkin, is actually potentially lined up well with spatial productivity, especially in future editions of applications and software like Apple Vision Pro, which is set to come in 2024. Number three is an app called Twos. And to be honest, this application is just a light-hearted note-taking application, but it's been growing pretty rapidly with a lot of community that are raving about this application. Now, Twos itself is very simple in nature. You can create simple list-based stuff, and you can even create tasks and even link notes together as well. But it has some neat and novel features, like where you can resurface notes that are on particular days so that you can look back at your memories and see if you've forgotten anything. There's also some really neat leaderboard functions and some great ways to be able to really take advantage of notes. It has quite a wide variety of applications as well, meaning you can get it on the desktop too, which makes it much more accessible. So next up is Reflect Notes. And despite being priced at slightly more, but not as much as the likes of, say, Roam and Evernote, it is definitely interesting me on the market. With a beautiful design, this application is a nice balance between a more intense application like Obsidian and a more traditional note-taking application like Evernote. It has all the hallmarks of the basics of Obsidian, like the ability to create daily notes, be able to see what's coming up with meetings, and also take full advantage of the markdown abilities too. But it comes in a really nice, well-rounded package that focuses on security too. And finally, an application that reminds me a lot of Notion. It's called Xtiles, and the application itself allows you to build little planner workspaces and also little visual workspaces that can be designed to your liking. But this application has been gaining a lot of attention with people who are looking for something that's slightly more structured than Notion, but gives you still the flexibility and customization of building your own workspace. This application is really an interesting option and one that I see growing in the market. So those are five new note-taking applications. As I mentioned, there's so many note-taking applications and a lot of them really interesting me. As the AI space evolves, I think note-taking is at the forefront of taking advantage of what you've put in a note-taking application and reintroducing the output to you, which I think will be pretty revolutionary. So thank you very much for jumping here on the channel today. If you're interested in finding a productivity tool or want to read news, setups, guides, lists, you name it, jump over to Tool Finder, which you'll find everything there. Thank you very much, folks. I look forward to seeing you in a future video. Do subscribe. Thank you very much, and make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.